Premier Colin Barnett has confirmed more than 1,000 public servants will lose their jobs over the next 6 months. State political reporter Alicia Banner joins us live from Parliament. And Alicia, there was mixed reaction to the news.
That's right, Nerelda. Over the next financial year, 1,200 public sector jobs will be cut. Of those, 200 will be forced redundancies. The cuts are just one part of a series of changes the government says are needed to keep the state's economy strong. But the move has been attacked by the unions and opposition.
1,200 jobs to go when we see 1,000 people a week coming to Western Australia means, you know, a cut to the services to people in schools, in hospitals.
And this will mean a further reduction, longer queues, children without case management and child protection, lack of offender management.
Voluntary redundancies for 1,000.
The redundancy package will be 3 weeks' pay for every year of service, plus an additional 20 weeks' pay in lieu of notice.
And the government will introduce special legislation that will allow them to force another 200 out the door.
Frontline services in our hospitals, schools and police stations are not excluded.
But job cuts weren't all. The government announcing new wage offers will be limited to the consumer price index, which is currently 2.75%.
Well, that will be the government's bargaining position in all wage agreements that expire beyond 2013.
A percentage pay rise at 2.75 when you're on $40,000 a year is not very much money. You know, our members are going to struggle.
The opposition accusing the Premier of double standards.
Those who are in Collins Club, those who work in the Premier's palace over the road, they get 52% pay rises, but everyone else, you get 2.75% pay rises.
But the Chamber of Commerce and Industry has praised the state government's action.
It shows the government understands the budget challenges that it faces and has introduced a package that goes a long way to addressing those while also empowering the public service to be more effective and efficient.
The Treasurer hopes the measures will save $2 billion over the next 4 years. Alicia Banner, 10 News.